what if you don't do it? It just won't be done. So Lord, do it for me.
Sometimes I get desperate and I say it like this. I say,
Lord, fix it for me. Anybody know that only God can do it? Oh, fix it for me. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Because, Lord, I have a problem that only you can solve. So, Lord, do it for me.
Can y'all play that for me?
You to do it right now. I can't wait till tomorrow. Do it for me. Lord, if you don't do it, it just
let the sound of worship be released from your lips tonight. Come on, raise it now. Oh, that's good, y'all. Raise it. In a motion.
Feel me, oh God.
till the dry bones respond. I gotta run over till cancer responds. I gotta run over till my family responds. I gotta run over. I wanna run.
Said he's been so good. God has been so good.
Good, just ain't good enough. You've been better than good to me.
God has had my back in the midst of my enemies, and I ain't even have to be there. I have roamed many cities, friends not very many, but God took care of me and my children. I'm so connected to this air that I breathe, the oceans and the sea,
the mountains, the skies and the trees.
I'm gonna get everything that belongs to me.
Good,
she said it's been so good.
His love flows like a river,
and it runs deep,
deep, deep in my soul.
Oh, his faithfulness.
I've seen enemies become footstools,
but because I love him,
I don't mind. He will never have a chance to have a seat at the table. Come on, Judas.
Hey, said he's been so.
Souls that were lost.
Hey, because somebody represented you in the wrong way. I call on you, Lord.
For the souls that were lost.
Hey, because some child watched mama run from pillar to post. I call on you, Lord.
For the souls that were lost.
Because papa was a rolling stone from bed to bed. I call.
For the souls that were lost.
Somebody could be contemplating
suicide.
It's
a do or die,
do or die
situation.
Yeah. Oh, but I trust you, God, because you've been real, real good.
Good, just ain't good enough. He's been really, really good to me.
Real good to me.
Hey. Praise the Lord, everybody. Good morning to the church. Good morning to the church. Praise the Lord, everybody. Can we clap our hands and give God praise, for the Lord is worthy to be praised. Oh, magnify the Lord with me. Let us exalt his name together. How many know the Lord is good? Can I get a witness? Oh, anybody know the Lord is good? Can I get you to wave your hand at least about it? Bless the Lord, oh my soul, and all that is within me, bless his holy name. I will bless the Lord, oh my soul, and all that is within me, bless his holy name. He has done great things. He has done great things. He has done great things. Bless his holy name. Come on, you sing it. Lead in. He has done. Come on. He has done. He has done. Bless his holy. Name. Can I get you to stand? I will. Oh, my soul. And all. Will you help me sing it? Holy name. He has done. Come on, everybody. Great things. Has done great things. He has done great things. Bless his holy name. name. Come on, he has done. Lift your hands and say he. Come on. He has done. One more time, he has done. Good morning. He won't be done. Oh Lord, do it for me. Lord, if you don't do it, it just won't get done. Oh Lord, do it for me. Come on, everybody, help me say, Lord, if you don't do it, oh Lord, do it for me. Oh Lord, Lord, if you don't do it, it just won't get done. Oh Lord, do it for me. 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 Anybody need him to do it? Wave your hand and say, do it for me. Oh, Lord. Do it for me. Oh, I need the every hour. Oh, gracious Lord, no tender voice like thine can peace afford today. Oh, I need thee. Oh, I need thee. Every hour I need thee. Oh, bless me now, my Savior. Oh, I come to right now, my Savior, Oh, I come to, Lord, if you don't do it, it just won't get done. Oh, Lord, do it for me. Lord, if you don't do it, it won't be done. Oh, Lord, do it for me. Do it for me. Do it for me. Do it for me. Somebody needs you right now, Lord. We need you to do it, Lord. Do it for me. Oh, do it for me, Lord. Do it for me. Lift your hand and shout, do it. Do it for me. Do it for me. Oh, do it for me, Lord. Do it for me. Somebody needs you right now, Lord. Go in the hospital, Lord. Oh, do it for me. I need you right now, Lord. If you need him, lift your hand and say, do it. Oh, do it for me. Oh, do it for me. Won't be done. Oh Lord, do it for me. Do it for me. Do it for me. Do it for me, Lord. Woo. I need you to do it for me right now, Lord. Oh, do it for me, Lord. Please, Sir Jesus, do it for me, Lord. The hell's hounds are blazing, but I need you to do it, Lord. Somebody is sick today, Lord. They need you to do it for me, Lord. Go in the prison walls. Save, Lord. Go in the hospital, Lord. Heal those who are sick, Lord. Go into the nursing home. And do it, Lord. Do it right now. Oh, we need you, Lord. Do it for me right now. Hallelujah. 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 Come on. Make a joyful noise unto the Lord. All ye land, serve the Lord with gladness. Come before his presence with singing. Know ye that he is God. It is he that has made us and not we ourselves. Come on, come on. Come on, clap your hands. Open up your mouth all over this place. Your neighbor, say, neighbor, I felt the shift. Tell him, I know God did it. Anybody felt the shift? Come on, lift your hands. Just give him glory right quick. Throw both hands up and thank him. Come on, open your mouth and tell him thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Hey. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. I feel like giving God the glory, all the glory, all the glory. I feel like giving God the glory. He has been. Come on. I feel like giving God the glory, all the glory, all the glory. I feel like giving God the glory. He has been, oh, so good, so good, so good. He has, so good, so good. He has. I came out to give God the glory, all the glory, all the glory. I came out to give God the glory. He has been, oh, so good, so good, so good. He has, so good, so good. He has been. Jesus, thank you, Jesus, thank you, Jesus. I came out to say thank you, Jesus. He has been, oh, so good, so good, so good. He has, so good. He has, oh. So good, so good, so good. He is so good, so good. He is one more time. So good, so good, so good. He is so good, so good. He is. He has, he has, he has, he has, he has been, he has been, he has been, oh, he has been so good to me. Good morning, good morning, good morning. He has been so good, yeah! He has been, he has, God's been, I said he's been so good, yes he has, yeah, been, he has been. Come on and help me. Will you help me say, thank you, Lord, for all you've done for me? Come on, say. Come on, say, thank you, Lord, for all you've done for me. Oh, you, Lord. Lift your voice and say, thank you, Lord, for. One more time. You done for me. 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 You done for me.
You ready now? Oh, you wet now?
Well, come on. Your neighbor, excuse me, but I gotta get it out.
Come on. Come on. Come on. Give God praise. Come on and give God praise. Come on and give God praise. This is worship. This is worship. Come on and give God praise. Give him the fruits of your lips. If he woke you up this morning, give him the fruits of your lips. Let the redeemed of the Lord say so. If he woke you up this morning, say so. If he clothed you in your right mind, say so. If he give you the activities of your limbs, say so. Let the redeemed of the Lord say so. We serve an awesome God. We serve an awesome God. We serve a magnificent God. We serve a God who can do all things but fail. Come on and worship him. He's worthy. He's worthy. He's worthy. He's worthy. I said he's worthy. Yes, he's worthy. He clothed you in your right mind. If you call someone's name that is in the earth, that is beneath the earth, they will fail to answer. But to God be the glory. We are here to lift up his name. We are here to shabak his name. We are here to give him glory. We are here to honor him because he has given us another chance. He has allowed us to see another day. And when this day passes, we shall not see this day no more. So he is worthy. He is worthy. He is worthy. Said he's worthy. Man is not worthy, but God is worthy. He's so good. He's so great. Matter of fact, he's greater than great. He's better than good. The Bible said, come and taste and see that the Lord is good. He's worthy. Said he's worthy. He's worthy. We serve a good God. We serve a magnificent God. We serve a magnificent God. What a God we serve. What a God we serve. What a God we serve. We don't deserve to be here. But thanks be to God for his grace and his mercy. Thanks be to God for his grace and his mercy. We don't deserve to be here. But we thank God that we are breath to breathe. Amen. 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 My God, the Spirit of God is in this place. 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 So we thank God for his Spirit, his Holy Spirit that dwells in us and dwells in the midst of us. So we thank God for his presence this morning. Amen. We thank God. Come on and give God praise in this place. Come on and thank God. We thank God. We thank God. We thank God. We cannot thank God enough. We cannot thank God enough for what he has done. He shed his own blood on Calvary cross that we might live. We cannot thank him enough. Because he did not stay dead, but he rose with all power in his hand. We cannot thank him enough. Not only he rose with all power in his hand, watch this. He's seated at the right hand of God, still making intercession for us. That when we mess up, I said when, not if, but when we mess up, he's just enough to forgive us. And when God look at us, yes, God. He see the precious blood of his son. Yes, God. What a God we serve. What a God we serve. Despite who we are. I'm not here to preach, but I just want to encourage you this morning. Despite who we are, we are messed up. We make mistakes. But despite who we are, God still loves us. God still loves us. The Bible said there is no good thing in us that is within our flesh. But thanks be to God that he looked beyond our faults and see our needs. And not only he see our needs, watch this, he attend to our needs. That's a loving God. That's a God who loves us. He loves us so much that he gave his only begotten son. Huh? That's the God we serve. So we thank God this morning. Be encouraged, people of God. Be encouraged. Hold on to God's unchanging hand. And turn this part over to the service to my dad, Reverend Hilton. Receive him.
Amen. Amen. The preacher is in the house. Amen. We thank God for Jesus. We thank God that God bring him here safely. Come on, somebody. God, when time a fresh word, turn to somebody and say, a fresh word. A fresh word. I don't know what you want this morning, but whatever you want, you're in the right place. Hashatarokobosa, feel something in this place. I'm feeling something in this place. I don't know, but whatever you want, whatever I want, whatever we want, whatever whosoever watching want on the internet, the word teach us that God said, not Hilton, God said, I will, not might, I will give you the desire of your heart. Amen, somebody. So whatever your desire is, you got it. Hallelujah. Come on, somebody. We have a fresh word. A fresh word is in the house, and we thank God for this young man. We thank God for this great, vibrant man of God, because just meet him for a couple times, I can see the spirit of humbleness and meekness upon him. And I thank God for him. Thank God from Pastor Moore, who was here earlier with us, our worship leader. Thank God for Reverend Hilton, amen, with the exhortation this morning, who have to go and do his own assignment. And we thank God for Minister Johnson, and thank God for you, my brother and my sister. We just come to worship God. We just come to give him the praise. We don't come here for no form. We don't come here for no fashion. And we sure that come here for no show. Amen, somebody. We come to give him praise. Nobody don't know where you've been through. Come on, somebody. Nobody don't know what you're going through right now. Come on, somebody. But we come to lift our hands and say, in spite of, you are still God. Come on, somebody. In spite of my feeling, I'm putting my feelings aside. But I come to praise you, because the word teaches us that everything that I breathe. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Everything that I breathe. Must praise E. Praise E. There is something about praising. I'm going to bring up my preacher, but I want to teach you something. There is something about praising God. You see, when we start praise God, that means you start pulling on his heartstring. It's when you start pulling his heartstring, he got to move. Come on, somebody. He got to move. Anytime you start pulling his heartstring, he got to move. God wants us to give us the fruit of our lips. He wants us to praise him sincere. Amen, somebody. That's what he created us for, to be praiser. And there is something about when you praise God. Something happen in church, out of church, everywhere something is happening when we praise God. And we thank God. We thank God. We thank God. We bless the name of God. We bless the name of Jesus. We bless the name of Jesus. My brother and my sister, listen. Only thing we have is love. And I need you to encourage yourself like what we usually do. And we're not going to stop encourage ourselves, because we know that we are what? Come on. We are more than conqueror. Come on, somebody. And if you know that you are more than conqueror, squeeze yourself. Start talk to yourself. Let yourself know that you are more than conqueror. Through Christ Jesus, that strengthens me. I can't do it for myself. But by the mercy and the grace of Jesus Christ, I can do all things but fail. Come on and open your mouth. Squeeze yourself. Encourage yourself. I don't need nobody to encourage me. But when I think of the goodness of Jesus and all that he done for me, my soul cried out, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus, for saving me. Because you have been so good to us. So good. Come on and encourage yourself. Encourage yourself. It's not going to be like this all the time. It got to be better. Encourage yourself. You serve an awesome God. You serve a great God. You serve a mighty God. Encourage yourself. Tell yourself, I love you in spite of who you are, I still love you. Come on. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. I know, Lord, I'm asking you, Jesus Christ, by your power of your Holy Spirit, that you will send a fresh wind upon your servant. God, as you take him from a mighty long way and bring him to us safely, God, I pray, God, that you will give him a rhema word this morning. Send a fresh word to our ears. Not make our ears be itchy, but God, send a word that will penetrate our heart, that our heart want to be changed. God, I pray that you will breathe upon him afresh in the name of Jesus. Rest your Holy Spirit upon him, God. God, I pray right now, God, that you will move in Macedonia Baptist Church this morning mightily, like you have never walked through this place before. Show yourself strong to your people. Show yourself mighty to your people. Somebody need you right now, God. So as I introduce this great man of God, he's not a stranger to the body of Christ, but he is your chosen God. You said, how can they hear without a preacher? How can they preach if they have not sent? God, you send him this way this morning for a purpose. We don't know the purpose, but God, you have a word for somebody in the name of Jesus. So I pray, God, that you will touch this young man. Oh, God, in the name of Jesus Christ, God, the pastor of the pastor of the Rock Hill Missionary Baptist Church. Come on, somebody in Renford, North Carolina. Come on, somebody in the person of Reverend Pastor Mack, A.D. Mack. God, I pray now, God, that you will use him mightily. You will allow him to stand boldly. And you will stir up the gift of your spirit within him. In the name of Jesus. Come on, congregation. Let us receive Pastor Mack in his own way as he come. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
Can we just lift this up right here?
Thank you.
Thank you, Lord. Help me sing it today. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. I just want to thank you. So good, you've been so good. Ooh, you've been so I just want to thank you, Lord.
How many know he's made a way?
He's made a way. He's made a way. Oh, he's made a way.
What did we come to say?
I just want to thank one more time. I just want to thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Do I got any thankful people in the house this morning? Hallelujah. We come to thank him this morning.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Can't nobody do us like Jesus.
Yes,
can't nobody save like he can.
Yes,
nobody can heal like he can.
Yes,
and he's the one that woke us up this morning. He's the one that did it for us one more time.
Yes,
and we come to shout, thank you, Lord.
Thank you.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
That's why we enter into his gates with thanksgiving. And into his courts with praise. And I'm so glad that we come to do what the Bible says, and that's to be thankful unto him and to bless his holy name. Amen. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. Isn't he worthy? To God be the glory, great things he has done. Grace and peace be unto each and every one of you from God our Father and Jesus Christ's precious Son. Our Savior and our Redeemer,
yes, sir.
Our friend, our way maker.
Yes.
Amen. We honor the Spirit of the Lord in this place, and we honor the shepherd of this house,
yes,
Pastor Evan Gray, in his absence. Amen. Come on, let's thank God for him.
Yes,
we thank God for Reverend Hilton.
Yes,
amen. He was so kind to pick us up from the airport and take us around and fed us, praise the Lord. Amen. To all of the preachers, all of the ministers, the sons and daughters of this house. Want to give a shout out to Rock Hill Missionary Baptist Church,
yes,
in the God blessed city of Rayford, North Carolina.
Amen.
Amen. They allowed me to step away for one Sunday. Amen. They said, Pastor, don't go up there looking for a church. I said, I ain't going nowhere. Amen. To my twin, she's here today, Izzy, Sister Naylor. God bless you. She flew up here with me. Amen. To Lottie, Dottie, and everybody.
Amen.
Amen. From the most infant baby to the most seasoned citizen, I greet you in the name of our Lord. Jesus to Christ. Amen. It's preaching time. And there is a word from the Lord today coming from Exodus chapter 17. Exodus chapter 17. Those of you who are able to stand, let us stand for the reverence of God's word. Amen. Hallelujah. We stand for the Pledge of Allegiance. We stand when the judge entered the courtroom. Surely we can stand for the word of God.
Yeah.
Amen. Exodus chapter 17. I thank God for my granny and my auntie. They're watching online. Hey, granny. Hey, TT. Amen. Exodus chapter 17. Put your finger on verse 11. I'll be reading from the New Revised Standard Version. It'll be a little bit different from what you might see in your Bible, but it's still the word of God. Amen. It says, whenever Moses held up his hand, Israel prevailed. And whenever he lowered his hand, Amalek prevailed. But Moses, his hands grew weary, so they took a stone and put it under him, and he sat on it. Aaron and Hur held up his hand, one on either side, so his hands were steady until the sun set. And Joshua defeated Amalek and his people with the sword. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. The grass withers and the flowers fade, but his word will stand forever. Holy Ghost, give me preaching power this morning. God, I pray even now that you would increase as I decrease. Lord, I pray that you would take me down into the storehouse of your word. And God, that you would preach through me, that you would preach to me, that you would preach to us, Lord. Men shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that comes from the mouth of God. And so, Lord, here we are in this preaching moment. God, I ask that you are glorified, that the people are edified, and that hell will be terrified. In the mighty name of Jesus, I pray. Let every heart say amen. 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 Exodus chapter 17 says, when Moses held his hands up, Israel prevailed. And whenever he lowered his hand, Amalek prevailed. Just for a couple of minutes this morning, I want to preach from the subject. I want to encourage us this morning to keep your hands up. Keep your hands up. Hallelujah. Go on and help me preach this morning. Say, neighbor, oh neighbor, just keep your hands up. Hallelujah. Just keep your hands up. Here we are in the book of Exodus, and we understand that it is the second book of the first five books of the Bible. We know that the first five books of the Bible, they're known as the Torah or the Pentateuch. Here in Exodus, this book is divided into two parts. It has 40 chapters. It has 1,213 verses, and it is the third largest book in the Torah. Now, the name Exodus, it means to go or to depart. And indeed, Moses would often write as the Lord would give him instruction. We understand that Moses is the author of this book. And in the book of Exodus, we see the life of Moses. We see his faithfulness to God and God's faithfulness to Moses. In this book of Exodus, we see Moses' fervency and prayer. And I don't know about you all, but I'm just like Moses. Whenever Moses prayed, God answered his prayer. Anybody know God to be a prayer answering God? Hallelujah. Have you ever had to call on him in the middle of distress? Have you ever had to call on him in the middle of the night when nobody else would answer the phone and all you could do is call the name of Jesus? And somehow, some way, he managed to answer your call. Hallelujah. I heard Grandma say, I know that prayer will change things. Hallelujah. Glory to God. The effectual, fervent prayer of the righteous, it will avail much. My brothers and sisters, this book, it reminds us that God remembers and he keeps his promises. And here it is, my brothers and sisters. My pastor, he always says this catchphrase, nothing catches God by surprise because God is always in control. And if you have not done so already, I encourage you to take your hand off of things and put your hand in God's hand and allow God to be God. Hallelujah. You just got to keep your hands up. I remember when I was in high school, I ran track and I ran cross country. And when I began to run track, I had no idea what I was getting myself into. I didn't understand the dedication that it took. I didn't understand the conditioning that had to take place in order for you to be a good runner. And I come to testify that that thing called conditioning, it was terrible. It didn't feel good when you had to drop down and do several push-ups. It didn't feel good when you had to lay down and do several sit-ups. It didn't feel good when you had to run lap after lap. It didn't feel good when the coach would cuss you out after you ran as hard as you could run. But it's something called, hallelujah, conditioning.
conditioning, and it did not feel good. My brothers and sisters, I come to tell somebody that, hallelujah, you got to keep your hands up. I remember my coach, he told us after we ran lap after lap that when you stop running, you got to keep your hands up, because when you keep your hands up, you're able to breathe a little bit better. And I don't know what it is that you're going through, but if you want to be able to breathe through it, if you want to be able to live through it, if you want to be able to stand through it, you got to learn how to keep your hands up. With my hands lifted up and my heart filled with praise, with a heart of thanksgiving, I've made up my mind to bless the Lord in everything that I go through. Do I have anybody in here that don't mind keeping your hands up in the midst of adversity? The devil thought it was over for you. He thought he had you, but I kept my hand up, and the more I keep my hand up, the more you can touch the hem of Jesus' garment. You ought to high five three people and tell them, keep your hand up, keep your hands up. The more you keep your hands up, the more God will bless you. The more you keep your hands up, the more God will heal you. The more you keep your hands up, the more faith and courage that you will have, that God will make a way out of no way. He'll open doors that no man can close. Gotta keep your hands up. Keep them up, keep them up, keep them up. I know the conditioning hurts, but keep it up, keep your hands up. I know that you're crying, but keep your hands up. I know that people left you, but keep your hands up. Hallelujah. That's the word for the day. Keep your hands up. There are three things that happen when you keep your hands up. When you keep your hands up, God will give you comfort in chaos. When you keep your hands up, God will give you power to prevail. When you keep your hands up, God will send help in heaviness. My brothers and sisters, here we are in this text. Moses is facing, hallelujah, a valley experience. Moses has had a lot of accomplishments at this point of the text. If you go back a couple of chapters, and I'll tell you some of the things that happen here in a couple of minutes. But Moses is in up against Amalek, the Amalekites. They decided that they wanted to attack Israel for no reason at all. Ain't that just like the devil? You've been serving the Lord. You've been minding your business. You don't bother nobody. And he'll come and attack you for no reason at all. So my brothers and sisters, Moses goes to the top of the hill. He got his staff in his hand. And Moses' staff is a sign of God's power and authority. His staff, it is a sign of leadership. It's a sign of God's comfort to Moses, and it is a sign of God's presence. My brothers and sisters, we got to take comfort in the fact that God is present in our chaos. And the reason why we're still strong is because God is our rod and our staff that comforts us. And we don't have to crumble and break during chaos, because God is evident and strong in our lives. Moses, he took his staff and he stood on the hill, and God began to comfort him while they were in the middle of a fight. My brothers and sisters, we can handle chaos the right way. Hallelujah. When we do that, it produces an anointing on the inside of us. When you handle chaos the right way, it causes us to tap into a level of comfort, because we know that God is on our side.
The reason you can have comfort in the midst of chaos is because we serve a God that's able to keep us from falling, and who's able to present us faultless before the throne of His majesty. The reason why we're able to find comfort in the midst of chaos is because we serve a God that will never leave us nor forsake us, but He will see us through until the very end. The reason why we're able to find comfort in the midst of chaos is because we serve a God that was able to make, hallelujah, the ocean split in two and to make a highway for His people on dry ground. The only way we're able to find comfort in chaos is because we serve a God that was able to walk on water in the midst of the storm. So you don't have to worry, you don't have to fret, be not dismayed, whatever be tied, God will comfort you in chaos. Tap yourself and say, yes, He will. Yeah, yes, He will. I know He will because He did it before. Hallelujah. I know He will. He gave me comfort when I lost my mama in October. I know He will. Hallelujah. He'll give you comfort when the doctors give you a bad report. He'll give you comfort when you got news that somebody in your family has gone to jail. He'll give you comfort when they lay you off for your job. He'll give you comfort when they stab you in the back. God is the mastermind of giving you comfort in the midst of your chaos. Hey, hallelujah. Woo, glory to God. Hallelujah. Not only will He give us comfort in chaos when we keep our hands up, but He will give us power to prevail. Well, if we look at the dichotomy of this text, Moses, he's experienced achievements and setbacks. He led the people across the Red Sea and sat there and watched the sea consume Pharaoh's army. Hallelujah. God, they had a praise break after they got across the Red Sea, and I believe they danced until they got thirsty. Hallelujah. They got thirsty, then they complained to Moses because they had no water to drink. And the water that was before them, it was bitter water. But God changed the bitter water into sweet water. Then after they quenched their thirst, the praise break was so intense, I believe, that they danced until they got hungry. And then they were famished. They got hangry. You know how we get at the church. We done danced and shouted, and now we want a piece of chicken, but when we get there, they out of wings, they out of legs, they out of thighs, and then they want to tell you, oh, it's 30 minutes until the chicken is ready, and you're, don't worry about it, I go cook my own chicken. They got hungry, and they complained to Moses. They threatened Moses, and so God had to give them some manna that fell down from heaven. Well, Israel still wasn't satisfied. They got thirsty again after eating all that greasy chicken, after eating some of that manna from heaven. This time, God commanded Moses to strike a rock, and water flowed from out of the rock. He had accomplishments, then he had setbacks. So now they're in a fight. Moses has grown tired now, and he's been holding his hands up. Hallelujah. Isn't it amazing? You've been fasting and praying. You've been going to church. You hear the pastor. Then you get on YouTube and you hear somebody else. But somehow, some way, you manage to get tired. Somehow, some way, you managed to grow weary. But our power to prevail is in our ability to keep our hands up. Aaron and her, they caught on to the revelation. They caught on to the fact that when Moses' hands are hot, then they have victory. But when Moses' hands begin to go down, they begin to lose the battle. My brothers and sisters, I got to tell you this just real quick, just in case you're grown tired just a little bit. Number one, the Bible says, be not weary in well-doing. For in due season you shall reap if you faint not. Well, let me put a twist to it. In due season you shall reap if you keep your hands up. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And my brothers and sisters, they caught on to the revelation that you got to keep your hands up. Keep it up. I know it gets hard at times, but keep your hands up. I know there are some things that have given you a headache. There's some things that have stressed you out, but keep your hands in the air. Don't wait until the battle is over, but go ahead and shout right now. Well, how do I shout? By lifting my hand. How do I shout? By stomping my feet. How do I praise Him? By shouting hallelujah. Hallelujah. Anybody got a hallelujah anyhow? Glory to God. Hallelujah anyhow. I know I'm surrounded on every side by enemies. Hallelujah anyhow, because the God that I serve will surround the enemy that's trying to surround me. Hallelujah anyhow, because I got power to prevail. I got power to overcome. I got power to have victory. Why? Because I'm more than a conqueror through Jesus Christ. And if you want to understand why I keep my hands up so much, it's because God has allowed me to overcome some Goliaths. He's allowed me to overcome some mountains. He's allowed me to overcome cancer and diabetes and all of the other stuff that come up against us. But yet and still, we're in the sanctuary lifting up holy hands because God has given us power to prevail. Hot five, your neighbor, say, I got power to prevail. Hallelujah. Excuse my poor language, but ain't nothing gonna stop me this time because I got power to prevail. Ain't nobody gonna be able to talk me out of it this time because I got power to prevail, and I got my hands lifted up. And as long as my hands are lifted, I got comfort in the fact that my hands are in God's hand. Hold to His hands. God's unchanging hands. Build your hope on things eternal. Keep your hands up and hold to His hand. Hallelujah. It's got to head back to North Carolina. But when you keep your hands up, He'll give you comfort in chaos. When you keep your hands up, He'll give you power to prevail. Then, when you keep your hands up, He'll send you help in heaviness. I'm so glad that God is our refuge and our strength. And He's a very present help in the time of trouble. Do anybody know that God, the name of the Lord, is a strong tower that the righteous can run in and be safe? Anybody know that you can look up to the hills from which cometh your help? Because all of your help, it comes from the Lord. My brothers and sisters, Aaron and her, they noticed that Moses' hands were going down. And they decided that one would get on one side and the other would get on the other side. They sat Moses down and they said, we're going to help you to keep your hands lifted up. My brothers and sisters, I come to tell you that God will send people in your life to help you. I heard somebody say, if I can help somebody, truly my living won't be in vain. So I come to tell you, stop saying that you don't need church folk. Stop saying that you don't like people. Stop making an excuse that you are an introvert. And learn how to accept the help that God gives you. My brothers and sisters, when you are down, God will send somebody to uplift you. When you are upset, God will send somebody to cheer you up. When you're too arrogant, God will send somebody to help you grow towards humility. When you are broke, busted, and disgusted, God will send somebody to bless you. When you are broken, God will send somebody to help to mend you. When you are sick, God will send somebody to doctor on you. When you are in trouble, God will send somebody to plead for you. When you are lost, God will send somebody, hallelujah, to rescue you. Ain't the Lord all right? I come to tell somebody that I heard of a story where there was a man on the airplane. And when they rose up in the air, they began to fly 30-something thousand feet in the air. And while they were smooth sailing, they were floating like a Cadillac and stinging like a Beamer. They ran into a very bad storm. And when they got in the middle of the storm, hallelujah, the pilot lost control of the plane. And the plane dropped down about 500 feet. And I know you understand the feeling when you're in a plane and it dropped down out of nowhere. And then, hallelujah, there was a man sitting beside a little boy. And the little boy was just like my nephew. He was all into the tablet. He was all into the phone. He was not paying attention. He was not worried. And he did not fret. And the man, he sat there and he said, how was this little boy just so calm when everybody else is screaming? Everybody else is clutching their pearls. And then when they finally landed, the man asked the little boy, how is it that you stayed so calm and you felt the plane drop? How is it that you kept your composure when everybody else was frantic? He said, the reason I wasn't worried is because the pilot is my daddy and he had everything under control. You ought to keep your hands up because God got everything in control. Keep your hands up because God, he know what he's doing with you. Keep your hands up because God got something in store for you. Ain't the Lord all right? Aren't you glad that you got victory on the other side? I come to tell somebody, we've come through hard trials and through temptations on every hand. Satan tried to stop us and place our feet on sinking sand. We've come through pain. We've come through sorrows. But the Lord, he kept us in the midst of it all. Ask somebody, how did you make it through? Because I kept my hands up. Ask somebody, what made you stop crying? I put my hands up. Ask somebody, why aren't you worried? Because I stopped telling people how big my problem is. And I begin to tell my problem how big my God is. Anybody know that God is bigger than everything. Ain't he all right? You got to keep your hands up because he kept his hands stretched. You got to keep your hands up because he bowed his head in the locks of his shoulder. You got to keep your hands up because he died. Anybody know he died? He died till the sun refused to shine. He died till the earth began to quake. Ain't the Lord all right? You got to keep your hands up because early, early, somebody shout early, early one Sunday morning, he got up with power in his hand. Ain't he all right? Won't he make a way? Won't he heal your body? Won't he walk with you? Won't he talk with you? Ain't he all right? Shout yes if you know it. Shout yes if you believe it. Shout yes if you agree to keep your hands lifted so he can comfort you. Shout yes if you agree to keep your hands up because you got power to prevail. Depression won't have you. Anxiety won't have you. Sickness won't have you. Failure won't have you because you got power, power to prevail. Yes. Got to keep your hands up. Moses kept his hands up with the help of God, Aaron and Hur, and he won the victory. You need somebody in your life that'll help you. Moses had Aaron. Moses had Joshua. David had Samuel, he had Jonathan, and he had Nathan. James had Peter and John. You need somebody to go with you. Paul had Silas, Barnabas, Apollos, Timothy. Look at your neighbor and say, you need somebody. Elijah had Elisha. You need somebody. Mary had Elizabeth. You need somebody to go with you. Somebody will help you. Last but not least, Jesus had the Father. He's the Son. And the Holy Ghost. So don't let life take you to a place of seclusion where you lock people out. When you lock people out, you can lock your potential to be delivered. But you need somebody that's going to hold you accountable. You need somebody that's going to tell you, baby, keep your hand up. Keep your hand up. If you put your hand down, you're going to lose. If you walk away from the church, you're going to lose. If you walk away from God, you're going to lose. But keep your hands up. And just imagine that the more you keep your hands up, your hands going to stretch until they reach heaven. Keep them up. Let us stand all over the building. Is there one today that does not know Jesus Christ as your Savior? Hallelujah. We live in an hour now. We need to be saved. The Lord is soon to return. And the Lord returning is not a scary thing. It's a good thing for those of us who are saved. Pastor, I'm not ready to be saved yet. I still smoke a little weed. I'm not ready to be saved yet. I don't drink liquor to have fun. I drink liquor to get drunk. See, some of y'all mad already. All right, a glass of wine is fine. A whole bottle, Be not drunken with wine wherein there is excess. The Bible says, be ye filled with the Spirit. Pastor, I ain't ready to get saved yet. I'm still a rolling stone. Temptation said Papa was a rolling stone. Wherever he laid his hat was his home. Pastor, I'm not ready to get saved yet. I be in everybody's bed except for mine and my wife's. Okay, I get it. But when you get saved, God will fix it. Not the preacher, not the deacon, not the trustee, but God will fix it. Only thing we got to do is come to him as we are. He'll take us as nasty as we can be, but he'll clean us up with his blood. Hallelujah. And then when you get saved and he clean you up, you'll be able to testify, things I used to do, I don't do anymore. Things I used to say, I don't even say it no more. Conversations I used to entertain, I don't even entertain them no more. People that I thought my friends, we're not even friends no more because they didn't want to get saved and I couldn't bring them with me because they wasn't willing to go. But the thing about it, when you make Jesus your choice, everything in your life will line up. I've decided to make him my choice. I don't regret making Jesus my choice. I made him my choice at 10 years old. Did I fall? Yes, I did. Did I slip? Yes, I did. I went to an HBCU. Of course, I was a mess. I was a wretch undone. I was blind and could not see. I was lost and I was not found. But since Jesus came into my life, hallelujah, I don't regret any moment of it because when I did fall, he picked me up. So the thing about having Jesus, it's better than all state stand. You're in good hands. But when you're in Jesus' hands, it's even better. You know, say Geico has good insurance, but the song says, blessed assurance. Jesus is mine. And Jesus' insurance and assurance is the best policy you can have. Look at your neighbor and say, you better check your policy. If you don't have a policy with Jesus, you ought to look. You better check your policy. How do I receive Jesus? Well, acknowledge him. Acknowledge that he is the Son of God, that God raised him from the dead with all power in his hand. Believe in him with all of your heart and confess that he is Lord of all. Every knee will bow, every tongue will confess that Jesus is Lord to the glory of God. That's all you got to do. Acknowledge, believe, and confess. And Jesus will take everything that's ugly about you and he'll make something beautiful out of your life. Is there one today, my brother and sister, that will receive Jesus? Don't wait till you're 50. He wants you now. Don't wait till you're 25. He wants you right now. Don't wait till you get on your deathbed. Let him use you while you're well. There's some people don't get saved until they're about to die. I mean, amen. But you missed out on so many opportunities for you to be a vessel for God to use you. Hallelujah. Would there be one today? My brother and my sister. Hallelujah. Come to Jesus just as you are, just now. Hallelujah. Everybody saved? Everybody saved? If you would like to join this church, Big Macedonia. Amen. Unite with this church as a member. The altar is open. Everybody's home? Look at your neighbor. Say, neighbor, are you home? If they was hesitant, grab them and bring them down here. Amen.
Amen. God bless you. God keep you. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord.
What a word, what a word. I tell you, it's a fresh wind. Amen, somebody. Fresh wind. We thank God for Pastor Mac for those powerful words. Just keep your hands up. Amen. Thank God, thank God, thank God. Here, everybody can be a part of the service. This young man coming from all the way of Ruford, North Carolina. We want to be a blessing to him. Amen. We want to let him know how New Yorkers do it. Come on, somebody. And it's not only that we are doing it because we are doing it to show, but when we sow seed into good ground, we shall have abundant harvest. Amen, somebody. And I believe this is good ground we are sowing in. I'm not going to tell you what to do. I want you to do it from your heart. Remember this morning, I tell you, whatever you ask God for, he will give you the desire of your heart. So whatever you have in your heart to do for the preacher, do the best you can. Amen, somebody. And I guarantee you will be blessed. Amen. Right now it is, those who are watching us virtually, we thank you so much to be in tune this morning with us. Amen, somebody. Because without those who are watching us virtually and those who are in the sanctuary, we could not do this broadcast without you. So we thank you for your faithful contribution. Whatever you give, God said he blessed a cheerful giver. These are the way of giving. As we see on our screen, you can give by Zelle. You can give by Cash App. You can give by Giveify. Also, you can give by the United States Postal Service. But God said, in whichever way you give, amen, he bless a cheerful giver. Let us be a blessing to this young man. Let us be a blessing to this young man. We want to be a blessing to him, amen. So we're going to leave it in the hands of our finance. Please, my brother, please, my sister, let we show him that when he leave Carolina and come into Macedonia, we are a blessing. Amen. God, he bless us. And if he bless us, we want to be a blessing in return, to be a blessing to him. Amen. We thank Deacon Dave. God, we thank Deacon Dave so much also broadcasting it because he was a part of the attachment to take our own pastor also. Sister Tanya, we thank you. And we thank our pastor, Pastor Gray. Amen. That we could be able. Oh, this is his Cash App right there. AD map, come on, dollar sign. Let us be a blessing to him, amen. We want to be a blessing to him. It is in the hands of our finance at this time, amen.